So just this week, the IRC has released its 2020 watch list. Here you can see the top 20 countries: Yemen, Syria, Nigeria, Venezuela, Democratic Republic of Congo are the top five on the list. And what's striking to me is how little this list changes from year to year. These are crises that last for many, many years at a time. You often have children who are born into refugee camps who don't know their home country.
That's a very good point.
Why is it that the need is so protracted and sustaining?
I think there are two reasons that are really important. The first is that we've got a genuine crisis of diplomacy. The tools of diplomacy that are developed for relations between states, which are suffering, just aren't adequate to wars within states. All of those conflicts that you've shown on the map are so-called civil wars. They're wars within states. The second thing that I think is very important is we're living in a world where power has been fragmented right around the world. And if you look at the UN Security Council today, it's not just split, it's deadlocked. And that's how I think you end up with these long-lasting conflicts that recur beyond generations.
You've said we're living in an age of impunity, where bad actors are free to cause great suffering. What do you mean by that?
I mean that you can, if you're a conflict player today, commit war crimes and get away with it. You can bomb coaches of schoolchildren and get away with it. You can besiege a city and get away with it. And the terrible thing about this age of impunity is that once it starts, it's very hard to reverse.